Hello YouTube, this is Tiki Bomber here, and I'm gonna give this message out there to all the female gamers that happen to exist in this powerful, painful world that feminism is trying to corrupt and coerce into their own will. Because if feminism can't control it, then it's clearly the age of patriarchy that's in control and all this other horseshit. Now, I'm coming at you as a female gamer, not as a feminist on this, because I feel as a gamer and a feminist, there's two different things to focus on. Feminism is more political, while gaming is more about enjoying yourself and having a good time. Sure, you can be political and enjoy yourself and have a good time at the same time, or you can be a gamer that's political, but the two should stay separate from each other because one is about being fun, especially in online communities, and the other one is more about getting involved with your offline communities, not online communities. So with that said, let me go ahead and give some advice to you girl gamers out there. Female gamers, actually. Girl gamers would be gamers like Brittany Venti, who play video games very badly, I will add in. I mean, with a kill-death ratio of like 0.75 to 11, it's really bad. You shouldn't play anymore until at least until you can get some coaching in first. Now, girl gamers do ruin the female gaming aspect for what is considered a female gamer in today's society, because they make it into a sexualized thing. They make money into making it into a sexualized thing. And while female gamers would be like, oh yeah, we know about that person, she's not really a gamer, anybody can become a gamer if they are taught. Give me a second. Excuse me. If they are taught how to play the game or how game mechanics work on the basic level. For a computer game, as an example, your basic mechanic levels are going to be the WASD keys for almost any video game. And I say almost because there's going to be a few games that don't use the WASD keys, and that literally throws the whole mechanic off balance in general. So, with that said, I'm sorry about the long pause here. I wanted to go ahead and give some advice about how to better prepare yourself against the trolls as well that you will meet. If people ask if you're a gamer girl, you can go ahead and tell them yes or no. It doesn't make a difference. But for me, myself, if you were to ask me if I'm a gamer girl, I would tell you no, I am a female gamer. Because I do try to distance myself from that sexualization for profit gimmick that most women, most gamer girls, or not all gamer girls, are using. There's very few gamers out there that are girls that don't do that. Or at least they don't want to be known for not doing that. They'd rather just enjoy themselves and play the games. And I hear a lot of these girls talking with guys in general. They're hanging out with them. They're doing whatever with their video recordings and stuff like that. And that's a good thing. That is a very positive thing to have happening. But for girl gamers, it's pretty much you're out there, you're putting your boobs on display for the world to hopefully get a nip slip out of it, and then you're also gaining money off of it, either through trolls or because of the fact that your fans happen to be horn dogs. Now, with that said and put to the side, I'm going to go ahead and tell you how I deal with the trolls online myself. And in order to deal with the troll in video games, because it is just for fun, you don't have to sit there and take that abuse. You can, you do have options for this, for the scenarios. You have a 16-year-old boy, and I'm saying 16 because this is the most common age I actually see these trolls start off at. You have a 16-year-old boy playing this game that you've been playing for a while now, and he hears you speak, and he starts going, "Oh my gosh, you goo! Oh my gosh, you goo! Oh my gosh, you goo!" Like, it's the most ridiculous meme I've ever heard, and I've heard it numerous times. And they say it like they don't believe you're really a girl, like you're some 10-year-old boy. "Oh my gosh, you goo!" You know, and I got sick and tired of hearing it over and over and over again. And being on a Team Fortress 2 server where voice was open for everyone, and I do mean open for everyone, I went ahead and got sick and tired of him, and I went, "Oh my gosh, you're retarded." Now, that's not to simply say that retardation is in fact a bad thing and could be related to this idiot gamer, but it is also something that he was doing him to himself. I took his whole narrative about the "oh my gosh" thing and turned it on him, which got the whole server rioting and laughing at him instead of sitting there going, "Oh my gosh, somebody shut this fucker up," type of deal. Which, you know, they were applauding, they were happy. I was happy because he was shutting up, but they were happy because, hey, he was put in his place. Let's keep playing this game now. And yes, most of the server was men. I think I was the only girl out of 16 players on that server at the time. When you troll somebody back like that, and the server hears it, or at least part of the server hears it, you know there is going to be a lot of laughter, there's going to be a lot of applauding for you, because you've literally stood up for yourself against somebody who's clearly an idiot. And that's not a bad thing to do. Feminism, unfortunately, in today's toxic society of feminism, wants to push the narrative that being a girl means you're an automatic victim and there's nothing you can do about it. I, being the less toxic version of feminism, depending on who you speak with, am pushing the narrative that women are not always victims. In fact, we can both be victimizers and we can help ourselves out. It is not that hard. More so with online community stuff. If you really get sick and tired of these 16-year-old trolls who start off trolling you, and you will know it too. As soon as you start to get this pattern developed, you will know that they are all 16, 15-year-old trolls trying to impress the masculine side by literally dissing on a girl because, hey, internet, I'm new here. I'm gonna be big one day. Respect me now. And you shut down that entire narrative in general with these guys. Now, I am not saying that all 16-year-old boys happen to be trolls, or that all trolls happen to be 16 years old. I am saying that for my time, I noticed majority of them being 16. Thus, it was oh, it was very easy for me to shut them down. When you get an idea of who you're talking to and who's making fun of you because of the fact that you're a girl, you will understand the age group. And you'll be like, okay, so this guy thinks that they're a big hotshot because of they just got introduced to the internet. Or they think that they're some big hotshot because of the fact that their friend happens to be a really good gamer. And that doesn't make any sense because just because their friend's a really good gamer doesn't mean that they're a really good gamer themselves. So, moving on to other things. Hi there, Allie. I'm giving a speech about how to deal with trolls in video games and defining female gamers from gamer girls. So, moving on to other things. I've noticed like more older men would use the "go to the kitchen and make me a sandwich" line. And of course,
I
my.
just got here.
Yeah, I know, I'm recording. And my line back to them is, okay, do you want anthrax or arsenic with that? Of course, they're like, what the fuck is arsenic or what the fuck is anthrax? Meanwhile, the rest of the server's like, oh shit, she's gonna burn you alive. Because I one way or the other, you're gonna die. More so when I was playing Medic on Team Fortress 2. That really pissed off everybody. But, you know. I learned to deal with trolls by trolling them back, and because of that, I still love video games. And I love the fact that I could play these games and throw around this trash talk like it's nothing, because it should be nothing. It is nothing more than harmless fun and an occasional burn with some aloe vera off to the sidelines for those burn wounds, you know? But You gotta learn how to deal with the trolls yourself in video games. Because you are just one person. If you really, and I do mean absolutely, really, cannot handle the trolls in these online video game communities, you're gonna have to dislocate yourself to another community or leave the video game alone. You can find other servers to play on. You don't have to play on this one server because your friend happens to play on it 24/7. You can find other communities and get better connected to these other communities. That's never going to change. Video games, especially online video games, is becoming a massive clique in its own sense. Yeah, I know, high school, but what the fuck ever. I mean, I'm part of this really great game server. I'm part of several game servers on Ark. But there's the one that I'm always playing on because I always feel welcome there, no matter what goes on. So with that said, just, you know, try on different shoes. See which one fits best and move on and then buy the pair. If you don't like the shoes because they're too ugly, if you don't like them because they're too big or they're too small, then just keep shifting around them shoes until you find the right ones to wear. Until next time, this is Tiki Bomber and Allie signing out. Peace.